I am Hari again on the cycle, and last episode we spoke about bicycle riding, isn't it? Did you go to the office by cycle, any chance, Hari?
Well, Manju, I would have loved to, but I'm working from home now, and so home is my office, so I can't really cycle when I'm in home, so no.
No, not at all. Okay, good. And for example, there are lot of reasons for well-being, isn't it? Even the sustainability development goals mention about the well-being of humans. So cycles also play a major role, isn't it? So how do you connect the well-being and cycling?
That's a really good question. So I think cycling is a great form of exercise. You know, for people like me, maybe we need to lose a little weight, which maybe cycling will help. Also, cycling releases some chemicals which are called endorphins, which makes you feel really good later on. So I think those are all reasons to that ways in which cycling improves the health and well-being.
And talking about cycling, Hari, I mean, Indian roads are not at all safe, isn't it? Unlike the Western countries, they have a separate tracks for cycling. And I remember Sunita Narayan, she met with an accident in Delhi, and she took a long time to recover because the roads are not safe for cycling. So how do you think one can cycle? Is it really safe to cycle in Indian roads, Hari?
Well, you know, I'd like to say yes, but really there are risks which you have to take every time you cycle. And it would be great if the people who are planning our cities could start factoring in cycling and building separate lanes for them to cycle in. And it'd be great if cycling became a movement and the other traffic on the road didn't view cyclists in an adversarial manner. So it would be great if we could all just get along. And I'm sure we'll get there though. Maybe not immediately, but I'm sure we can get there if we keep working at it. But in the meantime, I think we should all be very careful of where we cycle and how we cycle. I know that I've taken a lot of risks in cycling, but...
Yeah, you've done a lot of cycling trips, right? Like last time we spoke. And tell me some interesting places you went to, the longest trip you went to or a riskiest trip you went to.
Well, one of the trips we went to was in Kerala. So we went down the coast of Kerala and we went all the way down the coast and until we landed up at Kanyakumari. We did 500 kilometers over 4 days.
Wow, that's really good. Uh-huh.
Yeah, it was a lot of fun.
Okay.
But the cycle chain kept breaking, I remember. And my friend Ganesh fixed it with his teeth one time.
Okay, really?
And, yeah. And
but don't you carry a toolkit or something like that with you, Hari?
Yeah, but we didn't know how to fix the chain. So okay. We knew how to fix punctures and things like that, but we didn't know how to fix the chain. So the chain of my cycle kept breaking and on one of the days. And, it was getting dark and scary and a lot of traffic was whizzing around. But I still remember my friend Ganesh picked up the chain and he bit it between his teeth. Until the chain got fixed, and then we went for some 20 more kilometers till we found a mechanic.
Okay.
And it worked out somehow.
On this World Bicycle Day, what is that one message to everybody?
Well, the one message is get out your cycle, just get onto your cycle and start moving. And it's great fun if you do it with friends like me and Manju are doing right now. So get pedaling and get healthy and stay safe.
Exactly. At least once a week, just take the cycle out and just start cycling. Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.